Can this 2-liter inline 3 make at least 2500 horsepower? Well, we're gonna figure that out today. We're starting with the bottom end, the most important part of the engine. It will consist between a mixture of billet and forged steel parts. In this case, forged heavy with the quality slider on plus 15, VVT on all cams. We're using the single turbo setup with the smart boost controller. As always, direct injection per cylinder, race intake manifold with nitro meth. Tubular race header, single outlet, no cats, no mufflers, none of that. So this new weekend river just pass 8 grand. Or 97,900 RPM actually. But we can do it a lot more, I believe. So I think let's leave it at, let's say 9,300, I believe. It's fine. Anyway. Already 11, almost 1200 horsepower. With the exhaust manifold that is so restricted. It's actually the outlet, but you know, same. So we're upping the compressor size a little more, because I've got a feeling this engine is gonna be pretty unreliable. If it goes below 5% reliability, then unfortunately we can't use this engine in this configuration in any chassis. So unfortunately, but if we're gonna do something like that, I might detune it around 2000 horsepower and use it. If that's something you would like to see, do let me know down below. As always, those pistons and rods aren't looking that great. But anyway, getting back to this, we're going to up the exhaust size a little more. With adding a little more cam and spring and lifter and tension, all that stuff. Up in the boost some more, 2300 horsepower before the engine decided no more boost for you. So now it's the fun area of this engine. Now we're gonna have to play with cam profile and all that stuff. And unfortunately we can't use this engine. That is a little bit problematic. Let's see if we rev it a slight bit more, 100 RPM to be precise. It does decently before the engine decides to yeet itself. So we're doing not too terrible. Let's go back to the top end and see if we can make just a little more power. There we go. Okay, that's looking good. Before it decided to yeet itself again, so let's lower the compression ratio a bit. I think that does help to a point. Once it reaches that point, it's no more. Can we run a little more intake size on the turbocharger? No, we can't. A little more boost, perhaps? No. A little less fuel? See, fuel is a tricky one, because once you remove so much fuel, the engine starts to detonate and do all weird stuff. It starts to get finicky. Let's see if we can we mess with this just a little bit. I think we can. Okay, it's holding pretty stable. So I'm going to leave it there. So we're going to do two dyno runs, one looking at this beautiful engine, one looking at the graph. Let's see what this monster sounds like. I hope it's good. And for a tiny engine, this thing sounds pretty good. Thank you so much for watching, and if you stay to this part of the video, thank you first of all, and second of all, hit that subscribe button because I've got a feeling you might like it around here. But anyways guys, have yourself a fantastic day, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye bye.